Hello everybody, this is quixQuery here, and today we are starting a brand new series. This is Project Ozone, Captain Mode. It's been a pretty popular pack recently, simply because of Ethos series playing Kappa Mode, and I thought that was pretty fun, and so I decided that I would try it myself, and so we are here. We've just gotten started a little bit because these starting few steps tend to be very, very similar in a lot of the different packs, but we've already seen how much more difficult Kappa Mode can be with this thing right here, this world interaction upgrade specifically. And I'll show you around what all's going on here in a little bit, but that world interaction upgrade that I made, and if we wait for this to load, there we go. Okay, world interaction upgrade. It requires electrotine alloy, some lapis, and some iron, and an iron pickaxe. Okay, that's pretty, looks pretty simple, except for that electrotine. But the electrotine is a smelted electrotine iron compound, which is an iron with this electrotine around it. Now, this electrotine is obtained from sifting sand in a sieve, and yeah, it has a 17% chance of dropping, and you need a half a stack of that stuff in order to get that, so you need to have sifted a whole several stacks of worth of sand before you can even think about actually fully completely automating your cobble generation. But fortunately for us, we started in a Botania Garden of Glass, which is why there's a piece of bedrock right here. And so what we can do, we can shift right click on the ground to give us these pebbles, which we were then able to create, put into cobblestone, etc., etc. So that actually eased up the process of this beginning game stuff a lot. But we have already done quite a few quests, opened up a few things, and gotten some good things, some very good things in all of this. One of these is this ultimate bin from Mechanism, which is super awesome. I love it. It's essentially like a quantum storage unit from Mechanism, and I'm super happy with it. But we've made this iron chest, and these are some of the other things we've gotten so far. I've died a couple times, which is why I have my head right there. But yeah, we have a bunch of different stuff around here. These are just storage drawers full of some of the stuff we're getting from this mob farm right here. And right now we're not even close to being able to pick up all the drops that we are getting from this. And so that is one of the first things we should probably be working on doing. However, there is something else that is a much bigger deal that I want to get into, something new, because a lot of the Sky Factory stuff has been done before. I have never, ever gotten into Agricraft, and I really, really want to. And so, so in order to get into that, we need to actually make this seed analyzer. I'm not sure how much this costs in Kappa Mode. Seed analyzer? Okay, let's see now. Glass pane, a stone slab, a wood slab, some sticks, and... Oh, okay, so that's not bad at all, actually. That just requires a few basic stuff, and then we can get straight into Agricraft and get some little crops growing on another little temporary island over here. Okay, so here we are. We got our seed analyzer, and so now it says our quest is complete. So let's claim these rewards. We're not going to worry about opening up chance cubes yet, because I tend to like to save those actually for the end of episodes, because they're fun. And so, even though... Yeah, anyway, so we are going to be opening them, just not yet. We're going to save them to the end of the episode. Oh, heart glass, I forgot. That's exciting. I don't think I'm actually going to be using this at all. But I don't really have a place for it. Let's just put it in the iron chest for now. But yes, we also have earned our agricultural journal. Which is from Agricraft, I believe. Welcome to agricultural farming, so on and so forth, the basics of farming. Okay, so it turns out this book doesn't actually tell us very much. It's this paragraph right here, and that's it. Yeah, I believe we put it in that slot in the seed analyzer. Oh wow, that opens it. Okay, that's good to know. But I think then we put seeds in there and see what happens. Maybe. Oh, okay. So we put seeds in there, and they've been analyzed to be 111 seeds, one growth, one gain, and one strength. And I think gain is the most important one of the three. Strength would be nice too, I think. I honestly have no idea how this works, what each thing tells us. Okay. Whoa, hey fancy. This is a cool looking page. That's all we got though. Okay, so what's our second quest? We need... Okay, so our second quest is crop sticks. Passive farm. Have some grass, I'm assuming is what it is. Oh, okay, that's what it's for. But crop sticks is our next quest. We got some crop sticks. Now we need potato and carrot seeds. And I think we've gotten some of those from sifting, but I could be wrong. Okay, so it looks like we need to put a potato in a crafting square, and then it will turn into the agricraft potato seeds, and same for the carrot seeds. How do we obtain these? Well, it's not very clear here, because, yeah. So I think we might just have to try and get them from loot bags or just from zombie mob and or just from zombie mob drops. I honestly have no idea though. Okay, so I've been opening up loot bags as you can see right here, and we now have, you can kind of look through, see some of the stuff if you really want to. You can pause the video, but we actually don't need two of these. They're essentially just like conduit. Yeah, they're like conduit wrenches, and that's all they do. We barely even need one, let alone two. So, okay. But we have opened up a bunch of stuff, haven't gotten any seeds other than melon and pumpkin seeds, and so I'm not sure how we're supposed to get carrots and all that. So we're just gonna have to see how that goes and continue on with some other stuff, I guess, because, I mean, we can't really progress into the mod if we can't breed other crops, because we don't have carrots and pumpkins. Carrots and potatoes, there we go. So we're just going to have to deal with it for the moment, and a little bit later, what in the heck is that? Is there coal in there? I don't know why there was coal in there. That's weird. But, our storage stuff, as you can see, the Minisio one is... Oh, no, it's not full, apparently. It's starting to get full. Okay, I guess let's work on something different first. So, let's upgrade that to a gold chest first, and that actually completed a quest right here. So, let's claim all the stuff from that. That gave us a wrench, a chance cube, and a gold diamond chest upgrade, which will let us upgrade this even further to the highest possible storage capacity for these chests. Super awesome. Let's see here. Now, that gives us some extra storage space, which would actually be really nice. I don't think any of those are helpful. We've gotten all of those before, I think. Let's try these out. This turns cobble into gravel, right? Woo! It turned all the cobble into gravel! I didn't expect it to turn all the cobble into gravel. Snap. Oh, wow. Okay, that was an unexpected surprise. Oh, man. I expected it to turn, like, one piece of cobblestone into gravel, not, like, you know, all of them. But, by the way, I did get some artifact armor from opening up all those things, which does help me come up here just about as fast. Anyway, it helps me maneuver around a little bit early game, a little bit more early game, so I can get around places without having to pillar everywhere. That is pretty unsafe now. Now, I just don't want to throw this at my massive tower right there, my goodness. Okay, let's actually test. How much does this turn into gravel? If we, like, lay a whole bunch of this stuff down... Okay, say we have a bit like this, if we throw it at it... Okay, so it's only a little bit right there. You can see didn't turn the whole thing into... Oh, wow, okay, that's interesting. And so then it turned that stuff into sand. That's actually very interesting. Okay, burst of inspiration. Okay, here we are. We got a grass block now. How did we get that? We got some grass seeds from Ex Nihilo, which you get from sifting dirt, right? Okay, so that's how we got grass, and you can see it's spreading. We put the grass seeds down on the dirt, so yeah. And so now we can actually bone meal that to give us chances at getting other things from these bushes, such as seeds, hemp seeds, I think, maybe. Aha, yes, and that's a bamboo shoot seed from Pam's. So you can see that I think we're on the right track. We'll just have to see as far as that goes. Hey, carrot seeds from Agricraft. See, we are on the right track. That's exactly what I wanted. I'm not sure how much we'll be doing with Pam's Harvest Craft yet, and so I'm not really going to worry too much about what happens to those seeds. But now, because of that, we can go back to our beta quest line and turn in this... we've already turned in that quest. This quest right here, aha, claim, awesome, crop sticks is updated, and everything is going well. So the next one is... toast sandwiches. Oh, okay. Well, toast sandwiches are easy. Like, you know, that's just a bunch of wheat. Quantum entropy accelerator can provide 4 RF per tick. Converts matter to a little bit of energy. Huh. Does that mean... Hold up. Does that mean if I put cobblestone into here that it will produce power? It totally does. We are totally making RF from cobblestone. Nice. That is super nice. Thank you, Quantum Flux, for having that item. Oh, yes. Okay, so for making bread, I was just looking this up just to see what the best ways were to make bread. And it looks like there are some different flours and stuff that you can smelt into bread. Pam's Harvest Craft, which requires a decent amount of work. Some other stuff, including Ender.io and some stuff like that. But Natura, on the other hand, you can just put stuff in a crafting table rather than having to go through a sag mill or grindstone or anything like that. Flour in a crafting square, and you get wheat flour, which can then be smelted into one piece of bread each. And so for each toast sandwich, we need 2 pieces of toast and 16, which means we need half a stack of wheat, which we do not have yet. However, that is absolutely fine because we can grow some because we have some seeds, which is super awesome. Uh-huh. That into that, and then this can be smelted in there. And we are just getting sulfur dust from our mob farm over there, and it is actually in very, very large supplies. You can see that our sulfur dust is actually in higher quantities than our rotten flesh and our gunpowder and stuff, so no need to worry about the sulfur at all. So, yes, and that makes bread, which we then smelt into the toast, if I remember correctly. Okay, but anyway, while we're waiting on all of that bread to smelt up, because it is taking a long time because furnaces do, we're going to progress the rest of our stuff. in the alpha quest line. Okay, let's see, its survivalist generator is what we're going for next, and so that requires an iron furnace, which is pretty simple. It's just iron around a furnace, some compressed cobble, a piston, which, oh, that's another red alloy ingot. I only have two right now, so that's something we're going to have to craft up. Some copper coils, which we, I believe, actually have enough for. Let's see here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, and we got some... Oh, wait a second. Hold up. I put my hemp rope coil in there. There we go. Okay, and that gives us 4 copper coils, which we can then use in our recipe for our survivalist generator right here. So, yeah. So we're really close to getting that done. We just need to make that last red alloy ingot, which, by the way, is redstone around an iron ingot, and then put in the furnace. So, yeah, that's, again, Kappa mode for you. It's requiring a lot of resources. However, fortunately, they've been actually very generous with all the loot bags and stuff that we got from the farm. We got quite a bit of redstone, and so I'm not actually too worried about how this is going so far. It's not ridiculously grindy. It's not, you know, super confusing. It's, yeah, you know, occasionally I'll trip up a little bit, but I honestly have had a great time with this so far. And so, after, actually, hold up a second. I think we can do that. Yes, we can. That's actually, I think that's an old thing. I don't think you can do that anymore in vanilla, but, yeah, you can actually just, like, switch out the items as long as there's nothing in the, what's it called, right, the output right there, but... Piston! Okay, I believe piston in the middle, iron furnace below that, red alloy on both sides. We need our copper coils down there, and then some compressed cobble along the top, which we have another thing for right here. 1, 2, 3. Awesome. And then we just put that along there. Now we have our survivalist generator, which is good for this quest right here. Claim our reward. And awesome. Now we have to make another iron furnace because we had to make one for that in order to... Yeah, because the survivalist generator requires an iron furnace in it, but, you know, that's fine. We can deal with this. What are these clouds in the bottles? Right-click to throw. This will spawn clouds on impact. On an impact? Didn't impact anything, I guess. There we go! Aha! Nice, I like that. These could actually be kind of fun for decorating around the place once we've actually started getting in into our main base, which I'm going to keep a secret for the moment. You'll see what on earth we're going to do, and it'll be super duper cool. You're gonna love it. You guys are gonna love it. I promise. It's gonna be super cool. 16 toast sandwiches coming up. Here we go. This should be... Aha! There's our quest, and we can claim that. Awesome. And, ooh, enriched alloy from mechanism. I know what that is, and exactly what it can be used for in normal circumstances. However, this is Kappa mode we are playing, which means that it is actually used in a ton more recipes than I would originally anticipate. So, you can see it's used from stuff and completely separate mods and all that other stuff, and it's not used in places where it would be normal. And so, yeah, we are, yeah, Kappa mode. Exciting stuff, exciting stuff. but let us continue on this quest line right here. Let's see, netherwort, bakeware, and sugarcane. Well, netherwort's going to be the easiest one of those, because we already have some of that, so... Ta-da! Netherwort completed. We can claim our reward from that. That's super easy. Bakeware will be the next easier thing. However... Why does it say quest updated twice? What's going on? Let's harvest all this real quick so that we don't have to, worry about running short on all that later. And we can use toast sandwiches for our food now, which is, for at least a little bit, which is actually going to be very nice. So I'm totally making a fridge just to store all of our goodies. Our goodies in. And so we're going to put all of our cooking stuff, including wheat and all of that, into that fridge right there, at least for the moment, until the fridge becomes too small. Actually, hold up. I've heard that I think you can stack these on top of each other, so let's make another one and see if we can do that. Okay, moment of truth. Yes, we can. That is so much better. Yes. Okay, that is a proper-looking fridge. So, and it doesn't even need electricity to store all of its items. That's super cool. What just happened? What? That was not what I wanted to do. I did not want to dye you brown. Oh my goodness. Could have a black refrigerator. A black refrigerator wouldn't look too bad. How do we, what can we use for black dye? Let's see here. Black petal block, an ink sack, pulverized charcoal. Okay. Mechanism crusher. That would be probably the easiest way, except for the fact that mechanism is a whole tier of stuff to get into. You know what? Just for the sake of having fun, let's look up the crusher for mechanism and see how much it costs to get into mechanism. Okay, well, first off, it's steel. There's your first problem. Steel. Compressed iron gears. We're not even close to that. Steel casing, which requires a pressure chamber. Oh, man. Plastic. I don't even know what that is, where it comes from, or what. Thermal expansion? Oh my goodness, and then this energy tablet requires redstone alloy, osmium, a flux battery, which is vibrant alloy, and redstone, and glowstonic steel, which I have no idea what that even is. Oh man, this whole rabbit hole of crafting, just for a crusher. There is no way we are getting into mechanism today at all. At all. Okay, but anyway, our next quest... by the way, I have the sleeping bag I made from some wool, which is from some string and so on and so forth. But almost every single night here is a blood moon. Yeah, so I can't ever sleep. So it's pretty close to useless because I never use it to sleep through the night because... Yeah, I can't most of the time. Okay, so we just need to make all of the Pan's Harvest craft stuff, the mortar and pestle, skillet, cutting board, so on and so forth, in order to complete this quest. But we get a cinnamon sapling. That's actually pretty cool. That's a source of, cinnamon, which works as sugar in almost any recipe that sugar would normally work in, and so you can use cinnamon instead. So that'll be actually pretty cool to have. Looking forward to having that. And we get a juicer in as well. Okay, nice. Whoa! What just happened? Where did all my things go? No! Oh, come on! Oh, come on! Where's my transfer node? Where's my chest? No, get out of here, spider. I don't need you. Okay. This is a problem. A creeper literally just... I don't even know what has happened. Let's go up there and check it out here real quick before... Oh, in the storage drawers? Oh, come on. Yes, it's up here. Darn it. Fortunately, I have knockback resistance, which is super cool. That is incredibly frustrating. No, all of my stuff, it's everywhere. Just quick. Just throw stuff in chests, I guess. Sort it out later. My goodness. think this is the really valuable stuff. It freaking blew up a part of my refrigerator! Ah! Where did my refrigerator go? Ah! I was just sitting here, waiting for my last clay brick, and then all of a sudden, creeper, literally, like, down, right on top of me. It must have come from that ledge up there, and now we have this massive gaping hole, and all my items are everywhere, so, yeah, that is not what I wanted to happen today. Oh, man. This is not... That was actually very, very frustrating. Oh, boy. Oh, yeah, but now you can see the innards of my mob farm. It's actually not even that great. You can see these spikes are just upright spikes from artifacts. Okay, so that is one death, and you may think that was two, but actually it was only one, and here's why. Get out of here. But you can see, anyway, how wide that blast radius was. You can see that most of the blast was right there, and fortunately for us, our ultimate bin right here didn't blow up and make cobblestone fly everywhere or anything like that. But you can see our fridge over there, and even stuff all the way up here was blown up by that explosion, which is pretty insane. Didn't even have a chance to react. It just kind of happened, like... Wow, random things. Spirits are a little more hostile in this version than they are in other versions. It just kind of happened and everything was... Yeah, so we need to rebuild a bit. Let's do that here. Kind of still stuff is in a bit of a state of disarray because of, you know, big explosion, things go everywhere, etc., etc. So I'm just gonna recover here for a little bit and see our storage drawer, our chest right here, our like it's like it literally went to the things that mattered most and blew them up. I'm like, and he blew up part of my refrigerator. Why would you blow up part of my refrigerator? It wasn't doing anything to you. Ugh. Let's block off this lava so I don't fall in it again, because... Okay, so I didn't actually die. What I was saying earlier, I didn't actually die to the John Cena creeper, because that's what it was. It played the whole John Cena sound and everything. Like, it was legit. It was legit. But anyway, I didn't die to him because I have this thing right here. Allows sneaking on air when equipped and restores health after taking lethal damage with a 5-minute cooldown. So that's, yeah, that's what saved us, that bit of armor right there. And now we are, yeah, and so, but then after that, for whatever reason, I walked right into the lava. Don't ask me why. That was just, yeah, it's just what happened, don't question it. And so, now we have another death. Good for us. Let's finish getting things sorted back out. Well, oh boy, that was an adventure. That was an adventure, we'll just put it like that. I noticed our diamond chest survived, which is good. I hope it did. should hope so. But we need some better storage, an actual storage facility with, like, you know, some stuff like that. So, but in order to do that, I think we're going to use some iron chests to do that. Because iron is a lot easier to come by than a lot of other things. Namely diamonds and gold, specifically, so far. And so what we're going to do is we're going to end the episode off here. However, we will be back soon for another one, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Should be coming out in the next couple days. And by that time, we should hopefully have a Tinker's Construct smeltery up. And so we should be getting 2 ingots per each ore dust thing that we put in there. But I will note that we did lose an absolute ton of our stuff, including a lot of different dusts and stuff. Honestly, a little disheartening, but we can do it. We can totally do this. That thing is gone. Just completely blew up in the explosion. Yeah, our RF maker for cobble. We need to put down our thing again, our transfer node with our upgrade, which did survive. We have our world interaction upgrade right there, fortunately for us, because otherwise we would really be in a predicament then. Not as much because we have a ton of cobblestone, but still. I'm really glad this thing survived, but anyway, we're gonna end the episode off here, even though we did not finish up that achievement. You know what? We actually only need one more brick for that. Let's do this. Oh yeah, we also lost all the lava we had stored up in our crucible, which is another extra little thing, but we now have our last brick that we need for this, so that is actually very nice. Stop smelting! I forgot, we need clay for stuff. Okay, but that gives us our achievement, which is nice. That's what we set out to do. So let's open this up right here and claim all of our rewards. Woo! That's super nice. Very happy to have all that. Okay, now, let's open this up and then a tape measure. Ooh, nice. Very cool. From Bibliocraft. Might end up using that at some point. But just for the sake of keeping things fun, even though we just had something interesting happen, we're totally going to do a chance cube. And you know what? We're going to start the series off with a bang. We have some compact giant chance cubes, and so we are going to bridge out and... Oh, wow. That freaked me out. I forgot all about shifting in air. That was so weird for a moment. I was like, what on earth is happening? We're just going to come out here a little ways and open this thing up. Bwam. Oh, yes. Oh, prepare to die. Let's do this. Oh! Oh man! That literally just replaced all the blocks in that area with lava. Which actually, now that I see this, that's not too bad. Lava will definitely be a useful thing because, yeah, lava is a useful thing. It can power our Tinker Smeltery, it can do a lot of things. So that is actually, I will count that as a good chance cube. So, oh, I forgot all about our chance pendant over there. Anyway, but on that note, thank you so much for watching. My name is quixQuery. I'm in some kind of weird armor, but it's the best stuff I've found so far. Anyway, and I will see you in the next episode. Take care. Bye.